Hi, and welcome back to myexcelonline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to create a process diagram using the online version of Microsoft Visio. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So Visio is installed as part of the online package of office.com. In order to do that, you can go to visio.com and begin the download process and register. And then when you go to office.com, you should be able to go down here to apps, and the Visio app will appear right here. In my case, I've already clicked on the Visio app, so it's showing up right in my toolbar. But hopefully you already have Visio installed on your version of office.com. So once I'm inside of Visio, I can go over here to the flowchart template. And I'm going to use the template in this case because it's a lot easier than starting from scratch. So if I click on that, the online version of Visio will launch with all the tools that I need to make a flowchart. So for purposes of our video today, let's just make a really simple process of editing a book. So look over here on the left. I have some basic flowchart shapes. I have a process, a decision, maybe a sub-process, a start and an end, and some other information down here that's commonly used on a standard flowchart. So I'm just going to pull the start over right here. And then I can double-click on that, and I'm just going to type start, and then click out of that. And you can see that my font is really, really small. So I'm just going to go down here to this slider, and I'm just going to zoom in on my flowchart. And now I can see that I have my start location on my flowchart. So next, I'm going to bring in my first process of writing my book. And right here, I'm going to type research. And then I'm going to bring another one in that says write book. And then I'm going to bring one more process in that says send to editor. And then I'm going to scroll down and put a decision right here. And that decision is going to be need edits. And then I will bring my final process down here that says publish, and then I will end the process right here. Obviously, this is an overly simplistic view of creating a book, but it should just suffice for giving you an example of how to use a flowchart. So now that I have my shapes on for my flowchart, next I need to use my connectors. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So if I hover over my shape, you can see that I get these green circles outlining my shape. So if I click on one of those green circles, I can drag to my next shape and let go. And you can see that an arrow is placed in there indicating that my process starts with start, and the very first thing I'm going to do is research. So I'm going to draw these connectors, just holding down my left mouse button and dragging to the next step underneath. But once I come to my decision, I'm going to have two options here. If I need edits, I'm going to go back to writing my book, or I'm going to go straight ahead to publish. So if I do need edits and the answer is yes, I'm going to go back to writing more of my book, sending it back to my editor, and then seeing if it needs more edits. If I don't need any more edits, then I'm going to publish my book. And then finally, I'm going to go from publish to end, where I'm just going to collect all of my money from this great book that I've written. So one more thing I might want to do here on the decision point on my flowchart is I'm going to double click on this line and I'm going to write yes, because this is what happens in the case I need edits. And over here, I'm going to double click on this line and write no, because this is what will happen if I do not need any more edits. And I just want to indicate what both of my decisions are as soon as I'm at this decision part of my flowchart. So if I zoom out, I can see my whole flowchart from start to finish. I can resize and move boxes around if I don't like how the layout is. So if I go over here to design, I can change my diagram layout back and forth. Instead of being vertical, I can make it horizontal. I can also pick a theme if I don't like the color scheme that was by default. So let's say I want to go down here and choose this theme. I can also go to theme colors, and I can change some of those colors as well. So let's say I pick the Zephyr one. So you can see some of my shapes on my flowchart are slightly different than the others. So you can see that my start and my decision colors stand out from my regular process colors. Now this is a very basic flowchart, and these are the basic flowchart shapes. But you can go over here to this add button, and you can add other kinds of shapes that you can use if you have a reason to use a shape other than what's allowed in the default menu for the process flowchart. You can also make your fonts bigger, you can zoom in and out more. But I just wanted to go over how to create a really basic flowchart using Microsoft Visio so that you can edit it from there to more suit your needs. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks again for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.